Welcome everyone. We are going to start a new chapter today, which is in 12th NCRT, chapter number 9. It is Strategies of Enhancement of Food Production. In this, we are going to cover the botany part related to plant breeding. We are going to cover the zoology part related to animal husbandry. Now, what is the chapter about? It is the techniques or the strategies what we are using to enhance the food production, to increase the food production. What are the techniques we are employing? We are going to study under this chapter. Now, why food production should be increased? Because population is increasing dramatically, right? So enhancement of food or increasing in the food is a major necessity due to increasing population. That is our first point, right? Enhancement of food production is the major necessity. Why it is major necessity? Due to the increasing population. Because population is increasing, we have to enhance the food production also. Due to increasing population. Now, how will we try to enhance the food production? Now, what are the principles we need to apply? Means biological principles. Biological principles, if you apply in animal husbandry and plant breeding, will enhance the food production. So, NCRT says that biological principles applied. When we are applying biological principles, where are we applying biological knowledge? In animal husbandry, right? In animal husbandry and in plant breeding. When we apply our biological knowledge in animal husbandry and plant breeding, we'll enhance the food production. This technology will enhance the food production, right children? Now, what is animal husbandry? What is plant breeding? We'll see it in detail. Now, along with this, other new approaches like embryo transfer technology and tissue culture will further enhance the food production. That point also shall be right. So, along with this, we can write it as along with this, new techniques are also there, right? So what are the new techniques? I told embryo transfer and tissue culture. Along with this, new techniques. What are the new techniques? One is called embryo transfer. And what's the second technique? Tissue culture. Embryo transfer and tissue culture will further enhance the food production. Enhance the food production, right children? It will further enhance the food production. Understood till here? Now, when we talk about animal husbandry, what is animal husbandry? Try to understand first, then we will talk about plant breeding in the later classes. Now, what is animal husbandry? Let us try to understand. We'll talk about animal husbandry first. Now, what is animal husbandry? Means it is an agricultural practice of breeding, raising animals or livestock. So what is animal husbandry? I'm telling, it is an agricultural practice. It is an agricultural practice of rearing and breeding of animals or livestock. Animal husbandry, it is an agricultural practice of rearing and breeding of livestock. Now, this is coming to your mind, like, what is livestock, right? What is livestock? The domesticated animals, not the wild animals, the domesticated animals which are reared for the use of the mankind as called livestock. Means all those domesticated animals, if we are rearing them, if we are breeding them, there's nothing but livestock. So what is livestock? Livestock means
domesticated or domestic animals. Domestic animals reared for use or for profit.
All the domestic animals which are reared, which are cultivated for use or profit is called as livestock. Now, what are the examples of livestock? The livestock includes cattle, right? Cows, buffalo, camel we can take, then goat we can take, sheep we can take, horse, pig, donkeys, all these things comes under livestock only. If we want, we can take the examples.
What are the examples? I'm telling buffaloes. Then we are going with cows. Then we are talking about goats. Sheep, we can call them as cattle. Then coming to camel also we cultivate, right? Horses, donkey, pigs.
So all these come under livestock. So we cultivate all of them, and all these are categories of domesticated animals only. So we consider them as livestock. Now, animal husbandry, we are talking children first. What is animal husbandry? I told animal husbandry is agricultural practice of cultivating, of breeding livestock. What is livestock? Which type of animals are included in the livestock? So these animals are included under livestock. Extending with these animals, poultry farming and fisheries also come under animal husbandry. I'll write it here.
Extending to this means extending to the livestock, poultry farming and fisheries also comes
under animal husbandry. Not only just rearing the livestock, so it also includes, extendedly we can add poultry farming also, fisheries also. Now, what is poultry farming? Poultry farming means it is cultivation of fowls, right? So what is poultry farming?
Poultry farming includes cultivation of fowls. Fowls means birds, no children.
Poultry farming includes cultivation of fowls, birds. Which type of birds? Chicken we cultivate, turkey we cultivate, geese we cultivate, and ducks we cultivate. So that, why do we cultivate? For the meat and for the eggs. Altogether comes under poultry farming. So poultry farming includes cultivation of birds or fowls like.
Let us give down the examples. One is chicken, turkey, ducks, and geese
comes under poultry farming. Then let us see what is fisheries also. Fisheries include cultivation of fishes. Only fishes, huh? If we cultivate only fishes, that's called pisciculture. If we cultivate only fishes, what is it called? Pisciculture. I'll write it here.
Pisciculture includes cultivation of fishes only. It includes cultivation of fishes.
Whereas, what is fisheries? Fisheries is a broad term which includes cultivation of fishes also, shellfish, which comes under mollusks. It also includes cultivation of crustaceans like prawn, crab, like that. So, fisheries, shall I write down here?
It includes cultivation of fishes. Then I am telling it includes cultivation of shellfishes, which comes under mollusks, and cultivation of crustaceans.
Under crustaceans, we can take prawn and crab. We can take prawn and crab. All this comes under fisheries. Only cultivation of fishes is pisciculture. Whereas cultivation of fishes, shellfish, crustaceans like prawn and crab comes under fisheries. So fisheries, poultry farming, then cultivation of livestock, cultivation of honeybees also, apiculture, cultivation of silkworm also, sericulture. Everything comes under animal husbandry. Take a screenshot. We will continue.
Right? No.
have? Why do we cultivate all these animals? That should come into our mind, right? Why do we cultivate all the animals? Because we obtain some products from them. Now come on, think, what are the products we obtain from them? From cattle, usually what do we get? Milk we get, meat we get. And from poultry farming, again meat we get, egg we get. And from the animal skin, from the cattle hide, they make leather. Cow dung, right? Silk, we take silk, we take honey, all these are the products. Now let us write down, animals are reared for the products. What are the products? Let us list down. So, animals are reared for products. Like, so what are the products we are going to obtain through animal husbandry? So first comes is milk, then comes meat, then comes eggs. So after that we can tell, from honeybee we extract honey, from silkworm we extract silk, from goat and sheep we extract wool. So from animal skin, we cattle hide is used for leather making. Cattle hide is used for leather making. So these are the products we generally obtain from the animals through animal husbandry. What are they, children? Milk, meat, egg, eggs, honey, silk is obtained, wool is obtained, cattle hide or leather is obtained. These are the products we obtain. Now, animal farming or rearing of animals, is it such an easy task? Can you and we do it? So no, we tell it is a skill of a farmer. For us, it is a science, but for farmer, it is an art. We can tell animal husbandry as such, it is a skill, right? So all of us cannot control animals. So we can tell animal husbandry is as much as skill for the farmer. Only farmer can handle it properly. It is skill for the farmer, and for us it is a science. It is as much as science for us. It is as much as science for us, as much as art also it is. It is as much as art. So it is not possible for everyone to tame animals, to control animals, to love animals and to take care of it. Hence, it's not an easy thing we are telling. Now, for example, if we see, like, these are the animals. Now, how much percent of animals are there in India when compared to the world? It seems the statistical data tells that 70% of the livestock is in India and China only. See, 70% of the livestock is there in India and China only. Such huge proportion it is. Then when it comes to productivity, the productivity is 25% only. Why such low productivity? Means we are lagging in technology. So now it's a time we have to introduce technology in animal husbandry also, if you want to increase the productivity. Understood, children? So when it comes to the statistical data, we tell that India and China, right? India and China account for 70% of the total livestock in the world. It accounts for 70% of total livestock in the world. But when it comes to productivity, the productivity is only 25%. But the productivity, how much it is? We expect 70%. No, it's not 70%, it's not 50%, it's 25%. But the productivity is very low. How much it is? It is 25%. It is very, very low. Then what we have to do? So we need to, along with this conventional practices, we need to turn up and introduce new practices, right? So we can tell that, hence, in addition to conventional practices, new techniques should be implemented. We can write down. So hence, in addition to the old conventional techniques, in addition to the old conventional techniques, like, new techniques
are to be implemented. New techniques are to be implemented, are to be added. Why are we adding? To increase the yield. We want to increase the yield and we want to increase the quality also. Productivity we want to increase. And quality also we want to increase. Quality of the material also we want to increase. For that, we need to come and introduce new technologies. What are the new technologies? One is a professional approach. What do you mean by professional approach? Means better management practices. What do you mean by better management practices? Taking care of the animal properly. Maintaining proper hygiene for the shed, for the animal, and for the handler who is handling it. Proper vaccinating it, feeding it in a scientific manner, giving proper water for it, taking all these things comes under better management practices. So this comes under a professional approach. So let us tell professional approach. Professional approach. What is the professional approach? I told it comes under better management practices. Professional approach means, children, it is nothing but better management practices. What do you mean by better management practices? Taking care of the animal, taking care of its vaccination, taking care of its food, taking care of its how much water we need to give it, and regular visits to the veterinary doctor. All this comes under better management practices. Now when we do better management practices, we can increase, certainly we can increase the yield. So we will see some management practices in dairy industry. We will see some management practices in poultry farming also. So, take a screenshot, then we'll talk about dairy farm management first. Yes, now I told under better management practices, we are going to talk about dairy farm management. Which animals are maintained in dairy farms? Come on, think. Which animals are maintained in dairy farms? So, dairy farm management. Right, children? Now, which type of animals are included under dairy farm management? It is management of cattle, right? Why? For milk and for the other products. So, dairy farm includes, what does it include? Dairy farm includes the management of cattle, right? It includes management of cattle. Why are we cultivating cattle? For milk and other products. Cattle mainly for milk and the other products also. For milk also and for other products also. What is dairy farming? Dairy farming is an enclosure. It is an area where we keep the cattle, where we breed the cattle. So, and we obtain the products. We can tell dairy farming is an enclosure. Dairy farming, what is it, children? Is an enclosure. It is an enclosure where animals are kept, animals are raised, and animals are breeded. We will take care of animals in dairy farm management. Now, we are telling that some technologies should be implemented, some professional approach, better management strategies, dairy technologies. What do you mean by dairy technologies? Dairy technology means we're going to introduce the machines which will clean the conditions, which will help in milking and all. So that is one. Scientific equipment we are using, scientific approach we are following means how many feeds we have to give it, how much quantity we have to give it, in that how much protein should be there, how much fiber should be there. So we can tell dairy technology employs scientific equipment. It employs scientific methods. So we can tell dairy technology includes, what does it include? It includes scientific equipment, right? It includes scientific equipment. It includes scientific methods. What are the equipment? What are the methods we are using for rearing, for managing, and for breeding the animals? Methods used for rearing, for breeding, right? For rearing and for breeding and for collecting the milk, for storing the milk, right? And collecting and the storage practices, right? And the storage practices. So we got too much amount of milk and we don't know the technology, how to conserve it, how to store it. Then milk is perishable, it will spoil soon. So that is why we'll convert them into milk powder, we'll convert them into condensed milk like that. So dairy technology employs all the scientific equipment, scientific methods, which we use for rearing the animals, which we use for breeding the animals, which we use for collecting the milk, machines we use to take the milk out, and how do we store it, how do we conserve it, right? Now, how much percent of milk is consumed as such? Means only 39% of milk is consumed as milk. The remaining percent of milk is being converted into other forms. What are the other forms? Condensed cream, I told. Condensed milk, I told. Milk powder, we can tell. Kova, we can tell. Paneer, curd, buttermilk, cheese, all these are the other products, right? Some sweet dishes, all these are the other products which we make from milk. So we are telling only 39% of milk is consumed as such. Only 39% of milk is consumed as such. What happens to the remaining? The remaining milk is consumed in other forms, like the remaining milk is consumed in other forms. Children, what are the other forms? Come on, tell me. One is curd, right? Or yogurt, we can tell. Next one is butter. Then comes cheese. Then comes ghee. Then we can tell koa. Or paneer. And condensed milk, and we can tell milk powder. All these are the other forms which we take the milk. So it came with the dairy technology only, right? So to how to process it and how to store it in other forms, right? Come on, what did we discuss in this board? We were telling about dairy farm management. Dairy farm management means it includes the management of animals. Which type of animals? Cattle. Which type of cattle? From where we get the milk and the other products like this. Dairy farm management, it's a place where animals are kept. It's a place where animals are raised, where animals are breeded, where animals are handled. Now, dairy technology, we were telling better management, professional approaches will increase the yield. What are the better management? Dairy technology includes scientific equipment, scientific methods. Where do we employ these methods? In rearing the animal, in breeding the animal also, in collecting the milk, and in processing and storing the milk. So what are the processing devices? Means only 39% of milk is consumed as such. The remaining milk is consumed in the other products like curd, buttermilk, butter, ghee, cheese, paneer, koa, condensed milk, milk products, all these things. Take a screenshot. We will continue. Right, so we were telling by using this dairy technology, we were able to increase the milk production. So we are telling the increase in milk production is due to Operation Flood, okay, and White Revolution started in the world. So we can tell increase in milk production is due to, or was due to, I told it is Operation Flood. And other one important one is White Revolution.
Anything related to seafood is called blue revolution. Related to agriculture is called green revolution. Related to milk is called as white revolution. Increase in milk production is due to Operation Flood and white revolution undertaken by what are the institutes which helped this? Undertaken by institutes like NDRI, National Dairy Research Institute, National Dairy Development Board, National Dairy Corporation. So these are the institutes which worked out to increase the milk production. What are they? National Dairy Research Institutes. I'm writing it down. National Dairy Research Institutes. And what is NDDB? National Dairy Development Boards. It includes National Dairy Development Boards. NDC includes National Dairy Corporation. National Dairy Corporation. All these institutes helped in increasing the milk production, which is called as white revolution. Who is father of white revolution in India? His name is Varghese Kurien. Let us write down an important eminent scientist. Father of white revolution in India. Right? Who is father of white revolution in India? His name is Varghese Kurien. Right? An eminent scientist. Who is father of green revolution in India? M.S. Swaminathan. Who is father of white revolution in India? Varghese Kurien is called father of white revolution in India. Now, milk yield. We improved the yield. How did you improve the yield? It's primarily because of the breed. The breed what you selected. Jersey breeda, Ongole breeda, Halikar breeda, Sindhi breeda, like that. So, milk yield or increase in milk production is primarily due to the quality of the breed. The milk yield primarily depends on the quality. It depends upon the quality of the breed, right? What breed are you selecting? Halikar, Sindhi, Amrit Mahal, what breed are you selecting? Jersey breed, like that. It depends upon the quality of the breed. So that means selection of a good breed is very much important, right? So that means selection of good breed. So what do you mean by good breed? It has to give good amount of milk as well as it should be disease resistant also. So selection of good breed in terms of, we are telling in terms of good quantity of milk. In terms of good quantity of milk, it has to give good quantity of milk as well as it should have disease resistance also, as well as it should show disease resistance. So when you select such a type of breed, then the milk production will be more, right? So to increase the yield, so what are the better management strategies you are employing? So the better management practices, what do they include? So the better management practices include, so we are telling maintaining stringent hygiene. We have to maintain stringent hygiene for the cattle also, for the handler also, for the animal also, and for the person who is handling it. For the person also, for the cattle also, stringent cleanliness should be maintained. Providing water to the animal. Providing water. And then we are telling that giving the feed in a scientific manner. Now feeding in
scientific manner. What do you mean by scientific manner? How many times we have to feed? We need to decide how many times we need to feed and how much we need to feed. And what should be the composition also. It's not that all the waste material, straw and all you are giving. We should get good quantity of protein also, which will be reflected in the milk. So feeding in a scientific manner is also important, and providing vaccinating the animal should be done so that it gets protection from the diseases. And regular visits to the veterinary doctor is also important. Regular visits to doctor. Regular visits to the veterinary doctor is also important. All this comes under better management strategies. So we are telling that the milk production increased. So it is due to Operation Flood and the White Revolution initiated by certain organizations like National Dairy Research Institute, National Dairy Development Board, National Dairy Corporation. Now, who is father of White Revolution in India? His name is Varghese Kurien. Now, we are telling that the milk quantity depends upon the quality of the breed. Now, that means selection of a good quality is very important, plays an important role. Now, selection of a good breed means, are you checking only for the milk yield, or are we checking the other parameters, like it should be disease resistant as well? Yes, it should be disease resistant as well. Then we are dealing a professional approach, like better management practices. What are the better management practices that we can include under dairy farm management? Means maintaining hygiene for the cattle and for the handler, providing water to the animal and feeding it in a scientific manner, vaccination and regular visits to the doctor. Take a screenshot. We'll continue. Right, so when we talk about the cattle, so the one point which comes into your mind is cow and buffalo, right? Now we told a better breed. Now let us see what are the names of the breeds in cows and buffaloes. Now we can divide the breeds into two types depending on the origin. If it is a desi breed, Indian origin, we call it as indigenous breed. If it is from another place, we call it as an exotic breed. So depending on origin, right? So the breeds are divided into, so what is that I'm telling? One is indigenous breed, or we can call it as desi variety. The second one, foreign breed, is called as exotic breed. Okay, so exotic breed means foreign breed. Okay children, this is one way of classifying the breeds. Now if we have to list down some examples, yeah, we will see some examples under cows. What are the examples of indigenous desi cow? So we can tell Amrit Mahal, Haryana, Ongole. So these are some examples. Amrit Mahal, Halikar, Sindhi, all these are examples of desi cows, right? So let me write on Amrit Mahal, Halikar, Sindhi, Ongole, Haryana. So all these are some names of indigenous cow breeds. Now what are the examples of indigenous buffalo breeds? That also shall we write on. Indigenous buffalo breeds, we have to call, one is Murray, other one is Surti, and other one is Mehsana. Buffalo breeds example, one is Surti, other one is Mehsana, other one is Murra. So these are the indigenous desi buffalo breeds. Okay, so these are our varieties, our breeds. Now Nagpuri also we can write here buffalo breed. Nagpuri also we can include here. Now coming to exotic breeds or foreign breeds, under that buffalo breeds we don't get, but we can take the examples of cows. So under exotic cow breeds, so the popular variety where all of us are aware of is Jersey, right? So one we can tell Jersey. Red Dane is the other one. Red Dane, we can tell Jersey, the other one is Red Dane, other one is Holstein, right? So these are some exotic foreign breeds of cow. So since buffaloes are European varieties, so we cannot take exotic buffalo breeds. So we are telling that the quality of the milk primarily depends upon the breed. Then we are classifying the breeds. One way we are classifying the breeds basing on their origin. If it's a desi variety, it's called indigenous breed. If it is a foreign variety, it's called exotic breed. Indigenous desi cows examples are Amrit Mahal, Hallikar, Sindh, Ongole, Haryana. And indigenous desi buffalo breeds are Surti, Mehsana, Murrah, Nagpuri. Under foreign breeds of cow, Jersey, Red Dane, Holstein. Take a screenshot, we will see the other classification also. Right, so the other classification is based on for what purpose are we using. Right, children? So this classification goes with indigenous breed and exotic breed. And the second one classification will be depending on its role. Now that we are going to classify them under three types. If it's going to give milk, then such a type of breed is called milch breed. Now it's not going to give that much amount of milk, and if we use it for other purposes like agricultural farming and all, it's called draught breed. If you are using for the purpose of taking the milk, it's called milch breed. If it is used for agricultural purposes, then it's called draught breed. Now, if it is such an animal which can give milk also, which can be used as agricultural purpose also, it's called dual breed. Or the third one, it's called dual breed. Understood, children? Now, if we have to take the examples of milch breed, Sindhi, Sahiwal, right, Sindhi we can tell, Sahiwal we can tell, Murrah and Mehsana in buffaloes, these are cows, and in buffaloes, Murrah, Mehsana, these are buffalo breeds which give milk. So these are cow breeds which give milk. Now coming to draught breeds, Hallikar and Ongole and these things comes under draught breeds. Hallikar, Ongole, Amrit Mahal comes under draught breed, children. Coming to dual breed, Nagpuri, Haryana comes under dual breed. Nagpuri cow, Haryana comes under dual breed. So what is meant by milch breed? I told, milch breed means which gives better milk. So milk yielding variety, milk yielding breed it is. And draught breed means for agricultural purposes, it is for bullock carts and all, agricultural purposes. And dual breed means milk yielding as well as agricultural purposes, both milch and draught breed it is, then it's called as dual breed. Understood, children? Since we told the selection of breed is very important, we have listed down some breeds. We have classified the breeds basing on their origin as indigenous, I-N-D-E-G-E-N-O-U-S, indigenous and exotic breeds. The second classification we have done depending upon what role it is playing. Right, now we will see what are the products we will get from this cattle. Take a screenshot fast.
right? So come on, we list down what are the products we get from this. So the main product we told from the dairy farm, we get milk. So milk and egg is called as a whole protein. So the main product, what is the main product? The main product is milk. And milk, we call it a whole protein. It's a whole food. We call it as whole protein. Now, means what in all nutrients a person requires in terms of vitamins, in terms of minerals, in terms of proteins, carbohydrates, sugars, to the required amount, a balanced diet type of thing is there in the milk. So that's why milk is considered as a whole food. It's considered as a whole protein. That's why the newborn children, for a span of time, they'll be on milk feeding only, right? So the milk will supply their nutrients. They'll not be deficient of protein or vitamins or minerals, right? So this is the main product what we get. Apart from this, what do we get? And again, the milk immediately after parturition, what is it called? The milk which animal yields after parturition, what is it called? It's called colostrum. It is called colostrum. Colostrum is rich in antibodies. Colostrum is rich in antibodies. So it has immunogenic role. So it builds up the immunity. That milk is different. Normal regular milk is different. And the milk which comes after labor, after childbirth, the yellow colored milk is called as colostrum. Right? That is one. Another one we can tell, we obtain cow dung. This acts as an organic manure. It acts as an organic manure in farming. This is one product. And from using cow dung, we can get biogas, gobar gas, which is used for inflammation purposes. That's another use. So we obtain biogas, or since from gobar you are getting, it's also called gobar gas. This is another use. From the, we get meat. There's another one. Meat production we do. And now from the unused parts of the animal, gelatin is prepared, right? It is used in cosmetics, it is used in medicines, it is used in food preparations. From the unused materials of the animal body, they prepare gelatin. So gelatin preparation also they do, right? And other one, cattle hide, cattle skin is used for making leather. The cattle hide is used for making leather. All these are the products we are getting from dairy farm management. What are they? The main though it is milk. So milk is a whole protein. It is used for the newborn children also. And the first milk which comes is called colostrum. It is rich in antibodies, right? And it builds up immunity for the newborn baby. The second one is cow dung, which is used in organic farming. The next one is biogas or gobar gas, which is used for inflammation purposes. Next one is meat production also. Gelatin from the unused body of the animal, a jelly-like substance gelatin is prepared, which is used in medicines, which is used in cosmetics and food preparation also. Next one, ice cream preparation and all. Next one, cattle hide is used in leather industry. Right, children? I think with this we covered everything related to dairy farm management. In next lecture we'll talk about poultry farm management. Any doubts, post me in the comment box. If you like the content, like, share, subscribe with your friends. Thank you.